What's up, it's the Coaster Craze, and today I'm at Six Flags America to show you guys everything that is new for the 2020 season. This includes coronavirus protocol in addition to just other new additions. So right now I'm walking to the park, and instead of like the usual parking, they actually will scan your reservation ID so they know you had a reservation for today, and they'll also scan the pass wherever you have to get into the parking. So it's really nice that they just know you're reserved by getting into the parking lot, and then we get up to the front entrance is when they'll scan your season pass. So the first huge change is the new front entrance, this building right here, as well as that one. And of course there's also a tent set up. This is temporary, but this has to do with coronavirus, so they can scan your temperature. So here they list the park policies, and you're gonna go in right over here. They also sell masks over here, which is really nice because you are required to have a mask to enter. And here's the temperature screening. There's a long line to get into it. And you're supposed to be kept 6 feet apart. And if you have a temperature above 100.4 degrees, you are not allowed entry. Here's some really nice landscaping in front of the front entrance.
Wear your mask, wash your hands, cover yourself, keep your space, sanitize often.
I don't know how well you guys can hear this, but there's
Together, we can all make sure a more day at Six Flags is safe, about the safety protocol
that the park is taking and what they ask of guests, which is playing
welcome
the speakers
back
right
to
here
Six
and over here.
There's a scanner right here.
So do the six.
And security checkpoints are right over here. Typical entrance where you scan your pass, like in the old days. Of course, they also have the 6 feet apart markers, which is great to see. But they got a nice new entrance sign for Flags and Quinn. That's looking really spiffy. Oh, it's great to be back in the park. It all looks really fresh here on Main Street. Of course, you can also see over there, when it talks about download our app, that's where the park maps usually are. Looks like, unless I'm wrong, they're not doing them this year. Instead, relying on the mobile app, which makes sense. Even though I'm disappointed because I love park maps. Here's where the Flash Pass is. It's closed off for today, I guess. And this is the entrance to the Hurricane Harbor Water Park, which I will not be doing. But there are no major changes, besides maybe some small landscaping and other like maintenance stuff. So, no big deal. We also have sanitizer throughout the park, which you can see right here. Unfortunately, it's not touchless, but at least they have a lot of them. You also, in front of the Grand Theater, have this nice little display thanking all the people that are helping out during the coronavirus. Some nice landscaping of flowers right here. That's really great to see. You guys can see that the Great Chase Kitty Coaster has received new paint this year. Same color scheme as before, but it's looking very fresh and not faded anymore, which is awesome. It's not open right now, but this is actually a new game that replaced the previous one. It's Axos. Pretty cool. And you can see a little bit of Harley Quinn right there. They have various superhero themed stuffed animals that you could win. I don't know if it's just me, but it looks like Raging Cajun, the queue around it, have a lot more landscaping and vegetation. It looks really awesome either way. It's just looking really fresh. And they have the mysteries going, which is fantastic. This sign is new, advertising different prices for the park to take use of Speedway. So I just got off a wild one, and wow, it was front row. It's a lot rougher than it was in previous years for some reason. I thought they retracted, but the airtime was the best I've ever experienced. That was absolutely insane. Just the quick updates. So in the full ride queue, they have 6 feet apart stickers, and the ride ops enforce that. They also have every other switchback closed off, so they can keep the 6 feet apart. And before and at the exit to the queue, they have sanitizer, which is really nice. They also have the 6 feet markers down for kiosks like the different ones. Looks like Gotham City Arena received some fresh paint, which is great because it's right next to the newest edition, the biggest edition. Which unfortunately is not open yet and won't open until 2021. But some of the things around it have opened. Like we got the pub, the Steelworks Pub, which is an awesome sign right here. Let's see right there. It is right by it. Got some plants and stuff. It's not finished construction yet, they're still working on it, but this will be a fully functional bar. The park's second after Hurricanes, which is in Mardi Gras. Really nice. And then one of the things I love is that the iconic Batmobile that's been here for so long, it always looks so ugly and just wasn't painted. Yeah, well this was either fresh coat paint especially that signal on the ground. That was always so faded. And the Gotham City benches look just excellent. So here's a mask break. So there's a tree in the park where you can take your mask off and stay 6 feet apart from people, which I think is a really great thing that they have that. So I'll do a full construction update on this, but here we have the impressive structure of Harley Quinn. It's been Sandy, which is a Zamperla giant discovery. And to spruce up the area around it again, will only this finally get an entrance key, which you can see right here, switchbacks. And look at this fabulous sign, all the landscaping around it. This just looks fantastic. Let's get the full angle with Harley and everything. Also to go along with Harley Quinn, we got the Gotham City Gifts, this new store that has opened up. And it looks really great inside, it's all fresh. I really like the look of it. They got all this different Gotham City merch. A lot of it's Harley, of course. And then also, we got some new games over here. They look great at the shot range. And we got Gotham City Engine House. Very cool. So I just got off the Joker's Jinx, and it is running great. And it also looks amazing because it finally received new paint. It's become infamous for how just choppy and like just ugly it looks with all the cracked paint. It's faded green, you can see the steel. Now look at that, that is sharp and beautiful. I love it. So they have walled off the kids' playground in Whistle Stop Park. Great move because obviously that's so hard to keep well sanitized and socially distant. I've heard they also did the same for the indoor playground, the Looney Tunes Prop Warehouse in Looney Tunes Movie Town, which is the other kids' section of the park. Also, I love them seeing, like, constantly throughout the park, sanitization of tables, benches, ride switchbacks. It's just really impressive that they continually sanitize everything in the park, not just ride vehicles, which I've heard they do about every 30 minutes. So not every ride cycle, but they do have everybody sanitized afterwards, so it's all right. So Superman is running excellent. It definitely feels a lot faster. And I think that is likely due to the new wheels. There's also a new lift chain, but that doesn't affect the speed. That just, you know, needs a replacement. And there's also new blacker screens. So there used to be the yellow ones, you can see right here. Now we have the black ones over here, which you can just make out. Make them out on the red train, which is on the transfer track. And it's the same type of restraint, the N and T bar, they're great. But you know, they need a replacement, they're falling apart. And these look really sleek, I really like the look of them. Also, I think to note, I don't know if I mentioned this before, but all rides are spacing, or at least every other row is blocked off, you can't ride it. And there was ride ops constantly telling people to put back on their masks in the queue, which is excellent to see. The employees here are doing a great job. I haven't seen a single one with the mask off. And they're all telling people who don't have their mask off to put it back on, which is really, really impressive. And also a great thing is, typically at the Superman queue, you exit through the gift shop, but they actually opened up this little area right here, so you don't have to go indoors at all, which I really, really appreciate it. This is new. This is Dallas says Party Pavilion, this little pavilion over here. This is the very dead zone of the park where they need to add something new. Like, look at this little area. It's kind of awkward. It's between Chesapeake and Mardi Gras sections. There's a celebration stage. Again, yeah, they definitely need to add some things, make it a little nicer looking. Here's another mass break zone. This one's right by Voodoo Drop over here, and right by Looney Tunes. Like, they built this little new wooden smoking area right by that one. Also, it's necessary to point out that this year you can do mobile food ordering for most food locations on the Six Flags app. I don't know how well you see this, it's coming in and out, but it's very, very useful, I would say, especially with, like, you know, social distancing, coronavirus and all. So basically, you put what you want from the certain place, you can check if it complies with mobile food ordering or not. And then if you have a season dining pass, you can apply that, or you can put a credit card, and it actually will access your location, so you can press prepare my order. Once you get right in front of the place, it'll see that you're in front of it, and you have to get to the place in a certain time window. So for me, it's 1:30 p.m. to 1:45 p.m. 15-minute time window, you have to get in front of the place between that times in order to order it, and then they'll prepare it. And then there'll be notification when the food is ready. Really cool and really high tech, and not too difficult to use also, which is great. This year they have a new stunt show in the arena. This is playing for NASA. Every year they have a new one. This one seems like themed or something, like maybe the War of 1812, since that was very fought in Maryland and stuff with the pirates and all. So yep, there you can see our one sneak peek at the water park for the day. And I think that's going to conclude just everything new for 2020. I really hope you enjoyed this video and just my overall thoughts. I thought the employees were great. They were very friendly throughout, and they were assertive when they needed to be in terms of telling people to put on their masks, keep social distance. It's very impressive. All the coasters and stuff were running one train, which was unfortunate, but it's understandable because the crowds are pretty light. It's made almost everything I walk on at like a one train wait, which is really nice to get things done. Again, I didn't go into the water park, and I know that lots of people are there, but overall, I think it was a really good day. I was very impressed with their social distancing overall. Again, there's always things they can improve on, like having the sanitizer, the contact list, and I wish more people were wearing masks. I would say about 9 out of 10 of the clientele were wearing masks, which is pretty good. Could be better. But all the employees were wearing masks, which is really great to set a good example. So thank you again for watching. This is the Coaster Craze, signing out. I hope you enjoyed. Goodbye.